All right, first up today, we are joined by a husband and wife acting team who starred together in the hit NBC drama L.A. Law. Michael Tucker and Jill Eikenberry were married well before that show began in 1970. And before that, Michael worked here in Milwaukee. He spent 3 seasons performing for the Milwaukee Rep.
Yeah, the couple is in town volunteering their time to help the United Performing Arts Fund, UPAF. And we are welcomed. We're pleased to welcome Michael and Jill to the Yellow Couch. Thanks for being here, both of you.
Nice to be on the Yellow Couch.
Nice to meet you in person. I loved L.A. Law.
Oh, you're too young.
No, not at all. No, just celebrating.
She just turned halfway to 100.
Oh, thank you.
Wow. Well, you're preserved very well.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a great show, though. It's a pleasure to meet both of you in person.
Nice to meet
you. Thanks for being here.
Thanks.
Yeah, this is exciting. So now you grew up a little bit in Madison, didn't you?
Yeah, I wasn't born in Madison, but my father worked for what was called Farmers Mutual then,
yes.
And now it's American Family Life. And so he was transferred all around. So I was like a couple of years in Madison, then into Missouri, then back to Madison. So I have friends from all kinds of different, and I went to Madison West for junior and senior year. So
yeah.
I have a lot of friends in Madison.
Oh, it's nice. And then you were at the Rep for 3 seasons.
I was at the
Rep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what was that experience like for you?
It was fantastic for me.
I love the Rep.
I kind of got my feet under me as an actor, you know, doing 6 or 7 plays a year, rehearsing during the day, performing during the night. You know, I really learned my trade here.
Yeah.
It was very important for me. I love Milwaukee.
One of the productions you were in was Waiting for Godot.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
And I have to say, I'm not musically or theatrically gifted like Tiffany is, so I haven't seen as much theater, but for some reason, that play stuck with me, and I saw it in college almost more than any other production I've ever seen. There's something freaky about it.
That's interesting that you say that, because it's his, like, his play.
All-time favorite.
And when we were recording, he courted me with passages from Waiting for Godot. I bet you haven't heard that one before.
No!
It was either going to be that or I'd sing By the Light of the Silver Moon. Yeah, it was a very heavy way to court somebody, but it worked.
It worked.
Yeah. Yeah, that's cute.
Talk about how the two of you then originally met, and you worked together before L.A. Law. Did they write the roles for you two?
In L.A. Law, yeah.
They did.
Yeah, that was a nice story. So Stephen Bochco, who created and wrote the show, also did Hill Street Blues, which was a real landmark television show. And we were old buddies, went to school together. So he asked us, he came to New York on a trip, and he said, we're doing a two-part episode where this couple comes to the big city and all these things happen to them, and it's very funny. Would you guys be interested in doing it? And we had never really worked together. We were married. We'd been in the same show occasionally, but never in a scene together.
I was the ingenue. He was the character guy.
Yeah.
So we didn't.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Okay, that makes
so
sense.
So we decided to do it. A lot of couples don't like to work together, and we had no idea whether we'd go for it or not. And we got on the set and we started to work, and it was like magic. You know, I thought it was like cheating. It was so easy.
I think so too.
I likened it to a hotel, to a trapeze act.
Yeah.
There was also a hotel involved.
Yeah.
To a trapeze act.
That's a whole other story.
You know, because like I have never been on the trapeze, but I'm assuming that when you know the catchers are going to catch you, you can try the triple.
Yeah.
You know, and that's what it felt like with him.
Working together.
All of a sudden, I was a braver actor.
Yeah,
you were nominated, was it 5 times for an Emmy, 4 times for a Golden Globe, and won the Golden Globe for Best Actress in a Drama Series.
Yeah.
You had a lot of performances that I thought were extremely moving in that show.
Thanks.
Is it okay with both of you that you're still so heavily identified with that show in particular?
It's kind of nice.
Sure, it was a good one.
Yeah.
It was a good show, and my character was great because she, you know, was kind of an innovator in terms of women's stuff. She was working hard for women, and today that's like an important thing. So
you know, and later there were shows like Ally McBeal and things like that, and shows where women had roles like that.
And Stephen Bochco liked strong women. He really did.
Yeah,
that's neat.
And you're still an advocate for women's issues. That's kind of something you've brought into your life with your own breast cancer story, and that's what you're doing here with UPAF as well.
Yeah,
Talk a little bit about how important that is to share and really advocate for women's health.
Well, it was an eye-opener for me to realize that because I was on TV and people knew who I was, I could have an effect on people. Mm-hmm. And when I was diagnosed back in 1986, it was incredibly, it was hidden. Nobody yeah. talked about it. It was, nobody talked about surviving it. I thought I was gonna die for sure. Mm-hmm. And so when I got more, I got celebrityhood, I decided to use that to show other women that they weren't alone. And yeah. it was hugely effective. We made a documentary about it with a lot of survivors, and all of a sudden people were saying, oh, you can survive this,
yeah.
And then
yeah.
then people are less afraid to check themselves, and
You interviewed Ripple Effect
Nancy Reagan as part mm-hmm. of that documentary, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
What's the secret, in your opinion? I'm sure people ask you this all the time since you've been married since the 70s. What's the secret, in your opinion, to making a marriage last?
Well, I never talk to her when she's next to me on the airplane.
Number one.
It was a theme.
Yeah.
But I think we should talk about UPAF.
But wait a second. We just have to real quick say that we think the secret is that you have to let each other change.
Yeah.
Because people change. Mm-hmm. And if you say it's got to be like it was when we met, and you have to be that person that I thought you were,
it's not going to work.
No.
Well, then you start to lie to each other, because people do change.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And everything changes. So, we're very lucky. I would say we are just really lucky. We seem to be on for each other's game.
Yeah.
If I feel like doing something, she says, great, let's try that, and vice versa. And
47 years or something.
That's amazing.
We have a lot of fun together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we make that a priority, and we have a good time.
UPAF.
Yes, yeah. And you're going to make UPAF a lot of fun.
I thought that was really cool.
UPAF is an extraordinary thing to have mm-hmm. in this town. The arts in this town have always been big. It's because mm-hmm. of the great German heritage of Milwaukee, but people have always supported the arts here. It's why it's a great town.
Yeah,
and we say to a lot of people who come in, actors here locally as well as people who come in from other parts of the country, and say, what do you think about the Milwaukee, the art scene, the theater scene here? Yeah. People think very highly of
well,
it.
Well,
it's kind of underrated.
It's a very good art scene mm-hmm. here yeah. in Milwaukee. It's exciting. It brings people downtown. It makes it, there's something to talk about all the time.
And the children's theater and how bringing kids into the arts, because now schools don't do that mm-hmm. The way they used to when I was a kid. And so it's really important that the kids get interested in the arts, and especially theater, of course, that's my love.
And if you support the arts, then we might get another job.
Hey, that's always good. And then you'll stay married. So people can have a conversation with you. That's what you'll be doing here. It's called Making the Case, an evening with Michael and Jill. It's tonight. It's at 5:30. It's at the Northern Lights Theater at Potawatomi. You can visit upaf.org to learn more as well and follow along with your story, but hopefully go and see you guys tonight for a nice evening.
Can we try to just say Potawatomi once or twice?
Yeah, just try and get it. Short, you can call it Pato. That's okay. That's okay.
We called bingo there once.
Yeah, we did.
A long time ago.
It's really fun.
Really?
Yeah.
Pato bingo then.
Pato bingo. Yeah, great to meet both of you.
You too.
Thanks so much for getting up early and being with us. We appreciate it.
Sure, sure.